In this video, I'm going to show you how to customize the colors of the How to Create an Online Course Tutorial Video Series website. Wow, that is a long stretch there. Hi, my name is Adam from WPCrafter.com, where I release a ton of content to help you get better results with WordPress faster. If you're new here, consider clicking on the subscribe button, and for video notifications, you can click onto the little bell off to the right, and links to everything will be in the video description box. So I'm talking about Lifter LMS. This is the plugin we used to create the online course website that you find in this video tutorial series here. And this is the organized playlist. I'll have a link to this in the video description box. If you have not been following along in order, there's 22 videos here that go over every aspect of setting up an online course website using WordPress. Now, I've been asked a few times, here's what the website looks like. And obviously you can change anything, colors and the layout and everything. We're using Elementor for the pages here. But I did make some interesting choices in my color scheme. I'll be one to admit that. So you can see when I do the hover, we've got this more of a feminine color. And I'm going to show you how to change colors like that. And the active colors, that blue, I'm going to show you how to change that. And when you scroll into the footer, I'm going to show you how to change some of these colors right now. Now, if you remember, we are using the GeneratePress theme. So if I go to Appearances and I click on Themes, we have GeneratePress right here and a custom child theme. Now, here is the website to GeneratePress. Now, I do have a link in the video description box for this, and if you did click on the link, I earn a small amount of money from GeneratePress. So the first and easiest option is to buy the premium version of GeneratePress. It's only $40, and it gives you more typography options, just options on top of options that are all easy to implement in the customizer area of WordPress. Now, I'm not going to purchase it in this video and show you how to use the paid version. I'm going to show you how to customize this without the paid version if perhaps you don't have it or don't want to purchase it or are unable to. So I actually kind of touched on this a little bit in one of the videos that we were setting up everything. My guess is it probably would have been this video right here, how to configure WordPress after installation. Most likely it would have been that one. So, but it was just a tiny bit at the end of the video. So here it is. So with anything with WordPress, when there's a free version and then a paid version, you could do all the stuff in the paid version in the free version, but you just have to get your hands a little bit more dirty and spend a little bit more of your time in order to accomplish what you want. So in your WordPress installation, under Appearance, you should have an option here that says Editor. Now, if you don't have this editor option, typically maybe you have a security plugin installed that is hiding it from you so that you don't accidentally break something by going in there. I do know that iTheme Security does that, and I talk a lot about how great that plugin is, and you might have it on my recommendation, and you'll have to go into the settings of iTheme Security to disable this actual option. I'm sure you could just Google it and it would come right up, or just temporarily disable iTheme Security so that you can get back into the editor area right here. So I'm going to go ahead and click on it, and we're going to see these files right here. Now, if you're not using the child theme that I provided, you'll see something totally different. This is just for the people using the child theme I provided to create the website. And what we need to do is click on where it says functions right here. So I'm going to go ahead. Actually, that's the theme functions. Sorry, I'm already making mistakes. Click on theme functions. Okay. And we're going to see a bunch of code. Don't worry about a lot of it here. When you scroll down, it's going to start to make sense for you. So when we scroll down just a little bit, we're going to see these options that look like this. And they're all kind of nice and organized. There's a bunch here, and there's a bunch here, And I think there's one more bunch of them right here. Okay, so you got these, actually, and you have another one. These are all the settings that if you had the paid version, you would have a visual interface to change. But because we're using the free version, we have to change it back here. So each of these blocks of settings, each little line will do something. Okay, so let me go to the first one. So here's hide title. Let me go to one, like, see, we have these names here. We're going to start seeing them that have color codes. So right here, background color. And here is the color code. Now, I do have a video in this series about colors, and I talk about color codes and everything. So this should be a little familiar to you. So we have a color code here. We have a color code here. This is one of those colors. This is probably that light color, that pinkish color. So if you wanted to change the link color for links in your content, you would just change this hex code. Now you have to be careful. It needs this little apostrophe deal in the front and the back, and you can't get rid of that semicolon or you might break something. So just make sure you're changing the color code only. Okay, and when I scroll down here, we're going to have more settings. Header background color. Let's see. So here's those navigation colors that we were talking about. So here's the navigation text color, which is kind of that off black color. So you can see these have the off black when they're just sitting there like that. And then here's the navigation background hover color. We aren't using that. It's the text hover color. So this F right here, that is what's generating when I hover that pink or whatever that is. And that's going to be it right there. So you would change this to the color you wanted. So actually, I'm going to demonstrate this right now because this would be a real easy one. So right now, demonstrating, I'm hovering and I'm getting this color right there. Now I'm going to go ahead and change it to black by entering 333333. So there it is. I just changed the numbers. I didn't mess with the apostrophes or anything like that. So if I click on update file like this, it's going to update. I can go here. I can do a refresh. And if I did it right, now when I hover, you see it doesn't change to that purple anymore. I'm sorry, the pink. I'm getting my colors all mixed up. So that's how you do it. And when you scroll down, all these colors should start making sense to you. So that was the navigation colors. And here it is, the text current color. This is generating that blue right here. So I can change that to whatever color I want, or if I wanted to make it the same black, I could do that as well. And all of these, you could just read them and they just kind of make sense, but you can spot the ones where I changed by knowing the hex code for those colors that I had chosen. So you can just go through here and change whatever you wanted. So there's also that footer area. So let's see, footer widget background color. So if I wanted to turn this, so let me see, if I go here and scroll to the very bottom, it's going to probably be the background color behind this right here. So let me go ahead and change that. This might be it, this might not be it. So let me change this to all threes, just like that. I entered six of them. I'm going to scroll down, I'm going to do a save, and that might be the right area. It might not be, it depends on the terminology. So I'm going to do a refresh. And okay, so that wasn't it. I wasn't positive that that would be it. So let's see. Actually, I entered the wrong one. It's footer background color. I don't have widgets. That's why it didn't change. So this is where I should change it. I'm going to enter my threes just like that. I will do a save or an update file. And then let me go here and do a refresh, and that should change my color right there. See, there it is. I got it. Changed it right there. So this is how you just go through here and change these colors to whatever you want. Now, when you scroll down, you got other options. There's some font stuff here. You might want to be a little careful, but you can change some default sizes here. So site tagline font size, it's set to 20. That's going to be the font right here. This tagline right here, it's set to 20, so I can make it a lot lower if that mattered to me. So I can maybe set this to 16. And then if I do a save, let's update this file. Let's do a refresh, and that should go down in size. See, it's smaller. So it's just playing around with these settings here. So this section here is mainly like the fonts, the sizes. And then this last one is about spacing. So these are in pixels. So if I wanted to change these spacings a bit, I would go ahead and play with these numbers. And that is pretty much all there is to it. So this is how you would go through and start changing these different colors. If you didn't like the colors that I chose, and I totally get it if you don't like it. You know, I'm going to redo this entire video series in 2018, and I'll probably have more toned down colors. But this is it for here now. You can also purchase GeneratePress Premium. It's a fabulous plugin. It would really go to support the developer, Tom, who provides phenomenal support, and it also gets you access to that phenomenal support. And like I said, I have links to everything down below. So that should probably answer all your questions that you may have about the colors that I chose. If you have any more questions, feel free to leave it in the comment section down below. I'd like to hear from you, and I do want to release more videos on this how to create an online course video series. Hey, thank you for watching this video, and I'll see you in the next one.